आई एम डॉक्टर रेखा शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, यूजीसी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर, राजस्थान, तुकड़ोजी महाराज, नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी, नागपुर. द फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल इज ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन टू फंक्शनल फूड्स एंड न्यूट्रोसिटिकल्स एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल आर टू इंट्रोड्यूस द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फंक्शनल फूड्स एंड न्यूट्रोसिटिकल्स, टू अंडरस्टैंड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ फंक्शनल फूड्स एंड टू क्लासीफाई फंक्शनल फूड्स. द रूल्स एंड रिक्वायरमेंट्स of six major nutrients, namely carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals and water present in foods are known to us. Besides these nutrients, there are certain health promoting essential nutritional factors present in foods which have protective and preventive functions for our body. The health promoting effects of foods beyond their nutritional value is gaining wide popularity. This extensive vision of nutrition has led to the concept of functionality. The principal reasons for the growth of functional foods market are aging population, health trends, and public education. Due to the increase in life expectancy and the number of elderly continues to rise to the total population, obesity, heart disease, cancer, osteoporosis and arthritis continue to climb in countries throughout the world. The advent of the internet has opened these doors for the wealth of information. Similarly, the consumers are becoming more alert to health claims and are eager to know advanced information about food products than before. In this module, we will study history and definition of functional foods and nutraceuticals. Dear learners, now in this module, we shall study history of functional foods and nutraceuticals. During the last 2000 years, from the time of Hippocrates, that is from 460 to 377 BC, to the beginning of modern medicine, there was little distinction made between food and drugs. Hippocrates, the father of medicine, clearly recognized the essential relationship between food and health and emphasized that differences of diseases depend on nutriment. The concept of medicine and food are isogonics, originated in ancient China and transported to Japan long ago. Similarly, the doctrine of Hippocrates, let food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food, has had a rebirth. In 1984, the first national project on functional food was initiated by a research team headed by Professor Soichi Arai at University of Tokyo. The project, entitled Systematic Analysis and Development of Food Functions, was sponsored by Japan's Ministry of Education, Science and Culture, that is MESE. The food value criteria were defined by three categories. First, primary function identified as functions of nutrients. Second, secondary function referring to sensation. And third, tertiary function as body modulating function of non-nutrients. During 1988 to 1991, the second project was taken up by Dr. Arai et al. On analysis of body modulating, that is tertiary functions of foods. The thrust of the project was on the tertiary functions of foods, that is body modulating functions of non-nutrients. With the advancement of DNA microarray techniques, the last project was undertaken in 1992, which focused on analysis and molecular design of functional foods. The sub-themes were body regulating food factors, body defending food factors, and development of technological basis specific to designing functional foods at molecular level. In 1989, Dr. Stephen L. DeFelice coined the term nutraceutical, which is a hybrid or contraction of nutrition and pharmaceutical, who established the foundation for innovation in medicine in 1976 in New York. In 1991, the Ministry of Health and Welfare Japan launched the world's first policy, namely Foods for Specified Health Uses, that is FOSHU, for legally permitting the commercialization of some functional foods. Each of the FOSHU products claimed a certain degree of health benefits. The first FOSHU product approved in 1993 was hypoallergenic rice, developed after immunological studies. These scientific activities was reported in Nature News with the headline, "Japan explores the boundary between food and medicine," which took everyone back of the old days saying medicine and food are isogonics. The research team investigated hundreds of fruits and vegetables scientifically for functional food components. The advancement in this latest science also involved the introduction of sophisticated methods, namely assessment of oxidative stress due to the food factors using XYZ evaluation technique, compilation of data on the structure, function relationship of non-nutrients, and evaluation of individual food factors at the molecular level using DNA microarray techniques. The initiation of functional food science as well as the implementation of FOSHU policy in Japan had a strong impact on many countries in the world, particularly in Europe. In 1995, the UK Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries and Food defined, or although temporarily, functional foods as those having components incorporated that confers specific medical or physiological benefits other than nutritional effects. The International Life Sciences Institute, that is ILSI Europe, addressed the present status by claiming that they stand today at the threshold of a new frontier in nutritional science. They also stated that the concept of food is changing from the past emphasis on eating to satiate hunger into emphasis on the potential use of food to reduce the risk of chronic illness. Nutrigenomic research institutions around the world were forming consortia to merge their activities aiming at evidence-based functional food science through cooperation in the development of systems biology. In North America, the National Institute of Health, NIH, provided financial support for an ongoing research project on the relationship between diet and gene and between diet and disease in collaboration with 9 research centers and 4 external affiliated organizations. Europe launched a 6-year project in January 2004 that commenced with the participation of 22 research institutions from 10 different countries. For this project, the European Union allocated a budget of 17.3 million euro. A research organization was set up in Oceania that specializes in gut health research, and New Zealand and Australia played a leading role. These initiatives were replicated in Canada, China, South Korea, Singapore, and other countries to form a global network. These countries launched a clear strategy to exchange information with each other and to invest their research resources in the domains where they can capitalize on their own strengths. Now let us summarize, learners. In this section, we have studied that the term functional food was born in Japan, and the Japanese were the first to observe that food could have a role beyond nutrient supply. Japan was the first country to legislate these products as foods of specified health use. Europe and American countries incorporated later the concept of added value of food. Nutrigenomic research institutions around the world formed consortia to consolidate their activities aiming at evidence-based functional food science through cooperation in the development of systems biology.